Imagine your teenager decides to live a clean life. No alcohol, no smoking, no sex or drugs, and maybe even becomes a vegetarian. Sounds great, doesn't it? Well, for most kids who adhere to a lifestyle they call straight edge, it is. But for some kids, they've taken it too far, way too far, with deadly results. Now it's done. The river wants to get out and fly. And look my right. Wouldn't it be nice? Yeah, it's kind of nice. You think that day that I said it right. But you know how long it's all in the list of things I never did. Now it's done. And the river wants to stop and do a little more. It's right to get by.
If you've ever seen a slide of a blood sample where the blood cells are just sort of bouncing off of one another and it's just kind of complete chaos. There's no real order to it. There's a lot of energy and aggression in the music. It's a positive way to get out your aggression.
Dateline the mid-80s, bands like Minor Threat were giving birth to straight-edge music. It was designed to be played fast and heard loud. Teenagers were mesmerized by the music and its message.
And the kids would go to watch them at different bars and clubs where they couldn't actually purchase alcohol. They would mark a black X on the kids' hands, which would tell the bartenders that they couldn't drink alcohol. And the kids would go in and watch the bands. They took on the name Straight Edge. And they made the X that was being marked on the back of their hands as their symbol.
Today, Straight Edge is bigger than ever. Three of the biggest bands talk to us about the movement.
Battery's a Straight Edge band.
Straight Edge is a lifetime commitment.
And we don't drink, we don't smoke, don't do drugs.
And also a part of it is, you know, avoiding promiscuous sexual behavior.
For me, Straight Edge was like, wow, what a cool way to live like a positive life. Every member in the band, Straight Edge. And if someone wasn't straight edge, they wouldn't be in the band anymore. I think that the only place I've ever heard of there being some sort of straight edge violent gang is in Salt Lake City.
Salt Lake City, where straight edge became hate edge.
Right when I rolled in, it felt really crazy, but it was definitely a lot different vibe than I've ever been exposed to.
And what you sensed was rage. The victims, anyone who disagreed with the so-called poison-free lifestyle of straight edge.
Hate edge takes straight edge a step further. They walk by, they might see some guy smoking a cigarette at a show outside, and they'll tell him to put it out. And if he doesn't, they will, they'll beat him up oftentimes.
There were even wilder reports, like skateboarding gangs of hate edgers terrorizing pregnant women for smoking and vandalizing merchants whose products they dislike. It all led up to an incident that shocked the city.
The original Biden Act that kind of sent everybody way off saying, hey, straight edge is dangerous, was what occurred was at a concert at a fair park here. A kid was, I think he had a glass of wine and was smoking a joint.
I mean, they don't like people who drink, and it's probably pretty apparent that I was drunk, but I mean, maybe I shouldn't have been smoking the joint. I'm sure, you know, I shouldn't have, but
these guys threw him to the ground and proceeded to start to try and carve an X into his back.
I mean, they have no right to carve me up like a turkey or something, you know.
Actually, these kids had more respect for the turkey. Some became vegans, hardcore vegetarians, and turned their rage toward protecting all animals.
And then when they got into that, then they started into even more extreme animal rights type of activities. But it led to them getting involved in illegal and lawful acts of vandalism, of bombings, arsons, that type of activities.
There are instances where education, peaceful protest, and trying to change things through legal means have obviously been tried and tested to the limit, and they're ineffective.
Once again, the music was part of the movement. Listen to Ultra Militants by Earth Crisis. The hardline vegan zeroed in on a target, the fur industry in and around Salt Lake City.
Probably the first ranch that was hit was our research ranch. It was hit in June 97. About a month later, there was 3,000 or 4,000 mink released at a couple of our ranches.
Animals are rescued. It's a beautiful thing, and the people who do it should be recognized for the heroes that they truly are.
Picture here is what happens when they go out and release these minks. They end up getting out, they get on the road, cars run over them.
But releasing minks was just the beginning. Violent action was the next step. Target, the Fur Breeders Co-op, a major feeding and research facility for the mink trade. The perpetrators, Josh Ellerman, Adam Troy Peace, and three other straight edgers. Their weapons, 5 well-placed pipe bombs.
The devastation in the fire was very serious. The fact that they would plant pipe bombs is a very violent and terrorist type act.
I am personally straight edge. Obviously, I would consider myself a revolutionary. At the Fur Breeders Co-op bombing the office building, and I do believe 5 or 6 of the meat trucks got blown up.
Were you involved with that?
Yes, I was.
And have you had any legal repercussions?
I'm going to be doing 35 years in prison because of that.
Ellerman cut a deal and had his sentence reduced to 7 years. To some straight edgers, he became a martyr.
Sacrificed their freedom to make another creature free, you know? And I think that's an amazing thing, and they should be commended for it. But at the same time, yeah, it's like we feel awful that, you know, these people are actually gonna spend time in prison, a lot of them, you know?
On Halloween 98, straight edge violence in Salt Lake City reached the point of no return. This time, the target wasn't in the fur trade. It was some other kids who made the mistake of crossing paths with 30 hate edge hooligans.
They just rolled up on the side, and the straight edgers, I guess what they call themselves, spit on my cousin's car, called the black kids in the car niggers, and they just got out the car, and that's when the fight started.
Minutes later, Bernard Apreza lay dead. He'd been cut open from his neck to his belly.
I myself, and I can pretty much speak for the entire straight edge movement, we do not believe in racism. We are strongly opposed against racism.
A tragic ending and such a waste coming from a group that began with the intention of doing good.
I was disgusted. I couldn't believe it. It makes me question why I'm even doing this, why I'm even a part of this. It blows my mind that somebody could take straight edge and turn it into that.
Now remember, the vast majority of the kids who live the straight edge lifestyle are good and honest people. It's just a very few kids who are making a bad name for the whole movement. We saw how Josh Ellerman was brought to justice for his role in the Fur Breeders bombing. But there are a couple of other straight edgers who have crossed the line. Adam Troy Peace and James Ray Blackman are hardline straight edge vegans on the run for crimes committed in Salt Lake City. Peace is wanted as a co-conspirator in the Fur Breeders Co-op bombing. Blackman is facing up to 15 years in prison for crimes against Utah mink farmers. Today is his birthday. If you've seen James Blackman or Adam Troy Peace, call 1-800-CRIME-TV.